I grew up at a very young age with a lot of hopelessness. My hopelessness started probably around the age of 4, even though I didn't understand what hopelessness meant. At the age of 4, I was molested. And my story comes where I had no hope. I could remember, you know, as a young child, when I knew what birthday wishes were about, I remember just praying that I didn't wake up the next day. That was my birthday wish. What child on their birthday wished that they don't wake up? And then as I grew up very angry, not trusting, very closed in. I remember when my mother used to pray on her knees. And I said, it's got to be something about this God that she's praying to. So I began to pray to this God, okay, if you're real, then this is what I need from you. I don't want to hurt anymore. I don't want to be angry anymore. And I welcome God in. There my love affair began. And I just was overwhelmed with the love from God. And that relationship grew because all I had was Him at this point. He sent me away later in my young adult years to Ohio. And that's when I got baptized in the Holy Spirit. And I really experienced the closeness of the realness of God. And that realness came where I could audibly hear His voice. And so I began to ask questions. I knew something was wrong now, and I had suppressed the memory of being molested. And from then, I asked God, why can't I receive love from others? Why does it feel like they're trying to hurt me when it was love? And I said, I need to know. And He disclosed to me everything that's happened to me, the molestation. He disclosed to me why I didn't like certain touches, why I, you know, couldn't take naps. He disclosed to me, He just uncovered everything, all of the truth, because I was living the lie that didn't happen to me. He began to open up my mind to receive His truth, because not only when He uncovered the truth, all of the pain rushed up with it, and all of the hurt just rushed up. It was overwhelming. But this God, I could feel His embrace. And I could just feel Him sometimes stroking my hair while He would talk to me and tell me how much He loved me. And so He was there with me at that time when I was being, you know, hurt. He was right there. He had never left me. And when I found out that He was always with me, that gives me hope. It gave me hope. It gave me strength. And I said, okay, I begin to walk my pathway to hope. So I've been in the field of social work for over 20-something years. And I'm currently employed at the Salvation Army. And I actually serve individuals who may be hurting, individuals who may lose hope, individuals who may feel defeated. I actually deal with that population every day. I run a program called Pathway of Hope. God is included in that. A lot of prayer goes on, you know, with clients who are open to prayer. A lot of, you know, just God, okay, enter into this place, just inviting the Holy Spirit into their hurt and pain. And, you know, and celebrate with them when they're getting it, when they can face the truth on their own. The hopelessness is of the enemy, and it's a lie that God will not restore you. He will.